What's up, everybody? I'm Alisa, rhymes with pizza, ding! And thank you for watching this video. I am making this video because we are all human and we all get sad sometimes. Today, I'm going to talk to you about a couple of reasons why we get sad and what we can do about that. I'm hoping this video will give you a new perspective on sadness and maybe even make you want to kiss yourself the next time you get out of a sad phase. That being said, let's get started. Pain is a part of the process of the human experience that you, a spiritual being, came here to learn and grow about. This book I'm reading, The Subtle Art of Not Giving a Bleep, talks about this Polish scientist. And this Polish scientist in the 1950s studied World War II survivors who had seen a lot of messed up stuff. While studying these World War II survivors, he found that a sizable percentage of them said that their painful and traumatic war experiences had caused them to become a better person. It caused them to change a perspective on their life. A lot of them said that before the war, they were really ungrateful and they made a big deal about the little things in life, the things that didn't really matter. And that after they managed to survive the war, they found themselves more grateful for the things that they had in their life and just a tougher person for being able to survive. A lot of them, to his surprise, answered that. Although they had a very, very painful experience as World War II survivors, a lot of them, to his surprise, weren't completely traumatized, but yet felt like they grew greatly from this painful experience. The fact that we experience sadness and pain as human beings gives us the opportunity to grow psychologically. This brings me to my second point. Pain creates change. When we get sad, we don't always have to see it as a negative situation. Sometimes the most radical changes come out of our worst moments. I mean, think about it. It isn't until you hit rock bottom and you find yourself eating ice cream in your bathroom sink crying that you decide to change the things that you're doing in your life. Sometimes it's not until you have that major breakdown that you're like, okay, something's gotta change. Because we all inevitably have to experience sadness, and because out of our sadness we create change, that brings me to my third point. Pain creates new habits. Listen, honey, all of your emotions are valid. So if you're feeling sad and you need to spend maybe 3 hours sitting in your bed crying, or maybe listen to a couple of sad songs to purge that sadness, you have every right to feel that. But after you're done with your sad episode, you're gonna make some decisions to help change your life because you are a freaking boss. You hear me? You are a boss, and this is your life. Take the actions you need to take to make yourself happy. You can do this by making a list of things that make you happy. Make a list of actions that will make you feel productive. Spend some time dancing. Spend some time being grateful. I can totally relate to this because it wasn't until I had a sad episode in my life that I had to create the change for myself and make a YouTube channel, make somewhere where I could create, make a platform where I could put the things I wanted and express myself the way I wanted to. However, I didn't discover that until, you know, I had a really, really bad breakdown. And out of my sadness came this channel. Alrighty, everybody, I hope this video was helpful for you. If you are feeling sad or having a period of sadness, know that you came here to experience different emotions, that out of your sadness will come change, and that out of your sadness will come new habits. Know that you are one freaking big deal, that you are loved. Thank you so much for watching my videos. Thank you so much for being subscribed to me. I love you all. I will see you next time. Bye.